Hello everyone, welcome to the course on antenna and wave propagation. In this session, I am going to discuss radius of curvature of a ray, or you can say a wave, in the troposphere. Okay, this is an extremely important question that prove that radius of curvature of a path or of a wave is related to the rate of change of dielectric constant with height. Okay, so I'm again repeating, prove that radius of curvature of a path or of a wave is related to the rate of change of dielectric constant with height. Okay, so that means you have to prove this question, may be asked in university exam, then you have to prove that radius of curvature is actually rho, and h is actually the height. So you have to prove that how the radius of curvature of a wave is actually depends on the rate of change of height. Okay, so this is what we have to prove. Okay, so how will we prove? And in the troposphere, because we all know that this kind of radio wave propagation is occurring in the troposphere, because it is written radius of curvature of a wave in the troposphere. So you have to take into an account of the tropospheric characteristic feature. Okay, fine. Suppose a radio wave is traveling normally horizontally, nearly horizontally in the troposphere. What we are considering? We are considering that a radio wave is traveling nearly horizontally in the troposphere, and its path is bent into an arc by the variation of refractive index with height. Okay. What we are assuming here? We are assuming that radio wave is traveling nearly horizontally, okay, in the troposphere, and its path is bent into an arc by the variation of the refractive index with height. Okay, so this is shown in the figure. Okay, so let me explain you this picture, because this is the refraction of radio wave in the troposphere, or the refraction of the radio wave is actually occurring in the troposphere. This is what mentioned in this particular picture. Okay, so just you consider that this is your earth surface. Okay, so this is your earth surface. Okay, and this is your center of the earth, you can say. Okay, so from the center of curvature of this earth, this is actually the troposphere. This is the height of the troposphere. So this particular belt is the troposphere. We know that the first layer is of the earth surface is the troposphere. So this is the upper portion of the troposphere, is the lower boundary, or the lower boundary of the troposphere, upper boundary troposphere. So this height is actually I'm considering to be dh, small dh. Okay, now this is the troposphere, means the lower boundary of the troposphere. So what we are considering, that from the earth surface to this point, suppose this is the point A, the height is h. We know that the troposphere is scattered at a height of 0 to 15 kilometer from the earth surface. So what we are mentioning, that h is the capital H is the height of the troposphere of the from the earth surface, height of the troposphere from the earth surface. And you can say in a more precise way that the lower boundary of the troposphere is having a height from the surface is actually capital H, and this is the upper boundary of the troposphere. You are considering the two different boundaries, so that means this is the incremental increase actually in the height. So that is why I am representing here dh. So this complete distance will be actually h plus dh. Are you getting my point? Sorry, from here to here it will be h plus dh, from here to here h plus dh. Since this is your dh, and this is your actually from here to here it is h, earth surface to this lower part. So this complete part from here to here, this will be actually h plus dh. Clear? In a similar fashion, this is the radius of curvature of the earth here to here. So that means this is the center of the earth. So from this center to the earth, center to this lower boundary of the troposphere, I am representing here the rho. Rho is the radius of the, so from the center of the earth to the lower level of the troposphere. Now this is suppose incremental value of the radius of curvature, that is d rho. So the complete distance from here to here will be rho plus d rho. Clear? Now I think it is clear that this is your center of the curvature, and from here to here actually you are calculating from here to here h, and this is your d, so the complete distance will be h plus dh. And since this is your considering the radius, so from here to here it will be rho, and this is the incremental distance that is d rho. So this will be completely rho plus d rho. Clear? This is the Earth surface. Now what is happening at this point? This is the troposphere. We are considering that the wave is propagating in this layer. Okay. So nearly horizontal. What I have written here, the wave is traveling nearly horizontal. That means at A point to B point, wave is traveling this much of the distance v into dt, because s is equal to vt. You know the distance AB, distance is equal to v into t. S is equal to vt. So v into dt, in dt time the wave is covering the v into dt distance from A point to B to point. Okay, so in this way it is actually displacing you can say that it is making an angle d theta. Clear? So this is an incremental angle of d theta, so that the wave is moving from A point to B point. Okay. And similarly, in the top level of the troposphere, if the dv velocity will change from v to v plus dv, so v plus dv into dt will be the distance from this point to this point. Clear? So now just moving on to the qualitative analysis. So this is all the representation of the diagram. So in the figure below, it is already mentioned refraction of radio wave. Now let v is the velocity of the propagation at height h. At h height from the Earth surface, we consider that here the velocity of the radio wave is v. Okay, and rho is the radius of the curvature of the wave. Rho is the radius of curvature of the wave. Okay, and v plus dv is the velocity of the propagation at height h plus dh. Okay, so that means v plus dv, here the velocity will be v plus dv when you are considering h plus dh height. Okay, and h is the height of the traveling wave above the Earth surface. So above the Earth surface, h is the height. Okay, so clear? So h is the height from here to here, Earth surface, h, and this is your dh. Clear? This is your dh. So total distance will be h plus dh. Okay, fine. So since the wave would have move at a distance equal to v dt, as I explained earlier, that v into dt is the distance from A to B point, that is v into dt is the distance from this to this. So you can say that wave would have moved at a distance equal to v into dt along the curvature in dt time. So as described, an angle equal to d theta. So from this, from the figure, d theta is equal to AB upon rho. So can you write d theta, you know, in the plane angle, you know theta is equal to L by R. So d theta is equal to L by R. How can you write? How can you write theta is equal to L by R? You can write arc AB upon rho. Arc AB upon rho, isn't it? So this is your arc AB. Arc AB upon rho. So this is your arc AB, and this is actually your rho. So you can write d theta is equal to arc AB upon rho. So AB is equal to from here rho into d theta. Say equation 1. Now again, you can write AB distance is equal to V into DT. As I said earlier, that AB is the distance traveled by the wave. AB is the, B is this point, A is this point. So AB equal to V into DT. So you can write V into DT is equal to AB. Now say equation 2. Now equating equation 1 and 2, you will get rho d theta is equal to V DT, isn't it? So V DT is equal to rho d theta. From here, d theta by DT will give you V upon rho. Say equation 3. Now similarly at height, h plus dh, velocity will be v plus dv, as I explained earlier. So just put here in place of v dt, you just add dv. So v plus dv into dt is equal to, similar fashion, rho will be rho plus d rho at the upper level of the troposphere. So rho plus d rho into d theta. Now just multiply this, v dt plus dv dt is equal to rho d theta plus d rho d theta. Now v dt, rho theta will cancel out. Why? Because v dt is equal to rho d theta. I have written here v dt is equal to rho d theta. So just put v dt is equal to rho d theta, it will cancel out. So this will become dv dt is equal to d rho into d theta. So dv upon d rho is equal to d theta upon dt. Say equation 4. Now from equation 3 and 4, what we will get? Dv upon d rho, dv upon d rho, and place of d theta upon dt, you can write v upon rho. So that means dv upon d rho is equal to v upon rho from equation 3 and 4. So finally, dv upon dh. Why? Because d rho and dh are same. So you can substitute d rho as equal to dh. So dv by dh is equal to v upon rho. Why you are writing d rho is equal to dh? D rho is equal to dh because this is your actually d rho, and this is your actually dh from here. So here, okay, so if these two layers are uniform, so that means this height is equal to this height. So that is why you can substitute your d rho as equal to dh. So that is why this equation has finally become dv upon dh. I have substituted d rho as dh is equal to v upon rho. From here, just calculate rho is equal to v upon dv upon dh, isn't it? V upon dv upon dh. Say equation 5. Okay, now since a speed of light in a medium is given by v is equal to c upon root epsilon r, so it may be written as, we know that in a medium speed of light is equal to c upon root epsilon r, which you have already used in order to prove the ionospheric propagation radio refractive index. Okay, so this will give you c into epsilon r to the power minus half. This will go up and this will give you minus half. Now differentiate with v with respect to height h. So dv by dh with respect to height, differentiate. This will give you c constant and this will give you minus half into epsilon r to the power minus half minus 1, means minus 3 by 2 d epsilon r by dh. Simply you are differentiating with respect to height. So dxn by dx will give you nx n minus 1. So nx n minus 1, this will give you minus half epsilon r minus 3 by 2 and then function d epsilon r upon dh. Okay, so c, so this will give you dv by dh is equal to minus c by 2 epsilon r to the power minus 3 by 2 d epsilon r by dh. Now putting this value in equation 5, so equation 5 is actually your rho equal to v upon dv by dh. Just put the value of dv by dh in equation 5. So what we will get, v is equal to v upon minus c epsilon r minus 3 by 2 into dh by dh. So this will go up and 2 will go up. Okay, fine. So now put v is equal to here c by root epsilon r, or you can write c equal to epsilon r to the power minus half. So just put v in place of v, c into epsilon r to the power minus half. So c will cancel out and 3 by 2 will go up. So this will give you 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2. 2 by 2 means 1, means epsilon r. So 2 into epsilon r, this will go up minus 2 into dh by d epsilon r. Now nearly epsilon r is equal to put 1. So that means in the numerator part also, only numerator part. So minus 2 into 1 into dh by dr, so this will go down, this will be written as d epsilon r by dh. So finally the radius of curvature rho is equal to minus of 2 into minus of 2 divided by d epsilon r by dh. So this is what the relation which we have to prove, that how the radius of curvature is varying with respect to the height for a tropospheric wave propagation. So since it is actually varying, or it is actually decreasing, that is why this negative sign. What is the negative sign symbolic meaning? The negative sign signifies that the as we go up, then the radius of curvature is actually depending on the height. So that is why this equation shows the radius of curvature of a wave path is a function of rate of change of dielectric constant with height. Rate of change of dielectric constant with height means as we will go up, then the dielectric constant actually will change. This is a function of height. So this is what the entire proof of this particular question. Thank you.